Right, here you go. Okay, so I've pulled the first piston out, and yes, this is shiny inside. It's because it's been worn. If you feel it, you can feel crud in there. It's not so clean, and you can see it on this one that it's not so clean. So they're going to have to do a hone on it, the cut just a really small bit of metal out of it. Feel right here. Put your finger right there and feel that.
Here? Yeah, it feels like rough. And now my finger's
feel how, it's rough up at the top?
Mm-hmm.
Like it's smooth down here,
yeah.
And you come up and it gets rough? Okay, so that's called, that's a ring groove. Right in there's a ring groove. So here's the piston that came out. So this is the top of the piston.
Daddy, can I help?
No, but you can watch and ask questions. So this is the piston. And these are rings. See them moving around on there? See them?
Mm.
Quit messing with the zoom, please.
Yes, I do.
Don't mess with the zoom. Just keep it zoomed all the way up.
It is.
And then you can move it in yourself. So these two are called compression rings. And this one is an oil ring. So think about this, all right? When this... And this, I don't know if this is cracked or not. We'll figure out when we see the next one. So, let's talk about this, right? The piston comes up, and kaboom, we have an explosion, right? And then the piston goes back down. It would be this one, since both valves are closed. So, the explosion is what? It's a very, very super duper fast, rapid expansion of gas, right? But, that's what makes it work, right? This, you press all this up and you explode it, and it makes it push down because there's so much extra gas there, right?
Daddy,
what, Adam?
I'm going to the paper towel.
Okay.
Daddy, how do you take the piston out?
I will show you in just a
minute.
Are you
wearing white pants?
No, these are pink.
Anyway, back to this. Okay. So the compression rings keep that gas from blowing out around the side of the piston. You can't make the piston the exact same size as this. I've got to be very careful that I don't scratch anything when I do this. See, even there, it's a pretty tight fit. But it's not exactly tight. I've got this in the way down here.
How'd you take it out?
I'll show you in a minute. That's what she just asked, dear.
Oh.
So it's got to have, see how it moves a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta have that little bit, because what happens when this gets hot?
It expands.
And then what'll happen? It'll plug the hole if it's exactly the right fit, right? And then it won't move and it'll just break. So it's gotta have a little bit of room to move in there, like this. So that's what these rings do. When you squish these rings down in there, they get squished in like that. So there's no space in that gap. And they slide up and down. And of course, there's a little bit of space there, so you make sure that these two are not aligned. If they're aligned, then the gases will go on through. So you make sure one's on one side and one's on the other. But where they're always wiping on the side here, it wears a little bit off, which is why you got a rough spot up here on the top, because they never quite get all the way to the top, right? Because they're down here that far. So that far down is where that ring groove is. If you put in a brand new engine, when you rebuild them, if you don't cut that ring groove out, the very first thing that can happen is the new stuff can come up and hit that ring groove and break them right off and put a bunch of metal inside your engine. So then we talked about, so this thing is coming down.
It looks like a pendulum.
And going up like this, right? Because this thing's circular, right?
We'd it's like if I went like this.
Oh yeah, this thing's going in a circle. So if this goes in a circle, like this, but this is in a tube, so it can only go one way, right? So this is called the wrist pin, because it bends just like a wrist. This is the connecting rod. And this is where the crankshaft, where it connects to the crankshaft. So this is the main, this is the connecting rod bearing. Now in modern cars, these are shims. See these little holes, these grooves that are cut in here around this hole?
Mm-hmm.
That's a place for oil to go and keep the inside lubricated. And here on the bottom, in this super, super old engine, this goes on there that way. This thing comes down into this little pit, right? We talked about these little pits here the other day.
Yeah, the ones that are full of gross oil.
This thing actually comes down in there and scoops some oil up, and it blows up inside of here. That's how they keep this bearing oiled. In modern cars, the crankshaft itself has a hole cut in it that's called a journal. And the journal has high-pressure oil going in it. And this thing's not actually touching the bearing. This piece of metal is never touching that piece of metal, because that high-pressure oil is spraying out of there so hard that it keeps it from ever actually touching. So, if you look down in there, you can see the crankshaft. See the crank down in there? Going around?
Can I look?
Yeah, go ahead, look down, honey.
To walk off the stairs first.
See?
It smells.
Get back, don't. Don't
it touch. Smells amazing.
Okay, so down under here, I'm going to take this next one off.
Ugh.
So, if you see, there's the piston. Here's the connecting rod coming down right here.
I can't see.
Okay. Look in from right here. See it. So there's the connecting rod coming down to the bottom.
Okay.
See it there where my hand is?
Yeah.
All right, and now I'm just going to pull that off because I've already pulled the screws up. I don't want that to bang like that because that can scratch the surfaces. There's one of the shims that's broken. Now it's also important whenever you take an engine apart and put it back together that you put number one piston, or at least number one connecting rod, back in the same spot because of the way they're actually formed to it over time. There we go. So that comes off the bottom, just like that, right? And now I can turn this and it'll push it all the way back up to the top, like that. And now I just pushed it up with my fingers and it popped out. And now I just pull it out gently. And that does have that split, so that split's supposed to be there.
Or they're both cracked.
Or they're both cracked, but it looks exactly the same. Because I haven't been handling it as much. That's why. Now the other thing you got to be careful of when you put them together. See how that's got a mark on it?
Yeah.
In fact, that's got two marks on it. So when the guys rebuilt this, right, see this side doesn't have a mark. And this side does have the mark. And it's got two marks. So you know that this is number two piston, which is the position we just took it out of.
So this is number three.
One, two, three, four on this one, yeah.
This is intake and then exhaust, right?
From the look, yeah. That's an intake. These are the intakes. The ones closer to the I don't know. I just had to look. The ones closer to the back are the intakes.
So
now we're on the compression stroke on number
intake,
three. Yep. Now we go boom.
Outtake.
Exhaust. He goes
exhaust.
Down. And then as
and
it comes back
it
up,
out.
Exhaust, now he pushes the exhaust back out.
Okay.
And this is called top dead center. You're at the
all
very,
the way at the top.
All the way as top as you can get.
As far as you can go.
So.
I feel strong.
And then.
Yeah.
There goes those pretty fingernails of yours.
Nope, they're safe. I'll just wash them.
So. Good, they have marks on them, so I don't have to do anything special. And we'll see when we start putting this back together. Don't do it.
I'm not going to.
When we start putting this back together, I'm hoping that we can be a part of the rebuild. I talked to the guy and he said he'll let us come to the shop and help him be a part of the rebuild.
Yes.
So.
Can help rebuild an engine. Can help rebuild an engine.
We'll see how it goes. This is the reason that I can't rebuild this engine is these. This metal that's in
can
here.
Can I hold that?
Actually, let me get the other one because the shims aren't in it. So in a modern engine, this piece right here is cut out and there's a shim that drops inside of it. You can hold it.
Oh,
don't drop
pistons.
It though, you can break it.
Oh, pistons.
So this crack is here in the side so that when it expands, it'll probably actually seal up when it gets hot. So in the modern ones...
So nothing gets out?
No, in the modern ones, it's called an insert that drops in there. And it has this stuff in it and the hole. These old ones, this is called a babbitt. This is the actual metal that rides on the crank. So this is, for me to repair this, I would actually have to pour new metal in there. And it has to be the right mix of steel and lead and bismuth and whatever else is in it.
What is bismuth?
It's an element. And I can't do that. I don't have a forge. I can't make my own new, I can't pour metal. And then after you pour the metal, you have to cut it perfectly. They use a big drill to drill it out. So that's not something I can do, which is one of the reasons why I'm taking this to somebody else to have them work on it. There you go. So let's kill this for now. Oh, and here's another thing with these old engines. These wore, so these shims would go in, right? Just right there like that. So this is a real skinny piece of metal.
I can't see. Your fingers are in the way.
Right there. See the shim going right in there?
Yes.
So what happens is after a while, these start to get worn out. And these are soft metal compared to what the crank's made out of. So these wear out and the crank doesn't wear out. But then you hear it start to rattle. So remember when we first started it up, this engine rattles?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you come in here and pull these shims out and retighten them. And then it wouldn't rattle anymore. And you do that. And then the next time you had to rebuild the engine when it's starting to rattle, well, then you had to redo these. So that's enough for now. Let's turn that off.
Say bye.
Bye.
You have to look at the camera.
Bye.